Hey friends, welcome back to the most important topic of this linear programming problem, which is the solution of the LPP. See, simply I can say that this total topic is divided into three parts. Okay, so the total LPP is divided into three parts. In the first section, in the section number one, what you have seen is that the drawing the inequalities on the Cartesian graph. Okay, suppose we have the 3x plus 4y which is less than or equals to suppose 12. We have seen how to plot these type of lines in a Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, and we have also seen the feasible region for these less than or equals to ke satisfaction ke liye, how many solution sets we have for this inequality. The next section we have seen in the last videos, that is the formulation of the LPP from the given paragraph. Okay, from the given paragraph we have seen what are the constraints, what are the objective functions, whether we have to maximize it or minimize it, and what are the non-negative constraints, all those things we have seen. Now the third section is nothing but the addition of these two. Okay, if you are okay with the section 1 and section 2, then it is very very simple. Trust me, it's very very simple. It is just addition of these two. And fortunately, in this solution of LPP, they do not give you this big paragraph. They will directly give you the inequalities. Okay, we will see how the questions will be. Okay, but first let me explain this. What is the section 3 all about? This is our section 3. This is section 2. Okay, so in the section 2, we have seen that some of the questions like the manufacturer is manufacturing the toy A and toys A and toys B, and for that he will be having some constraints. Now what will be the maximum number of toys A and B he can manufacture so that he will get the maximum profit? Wo jo maximum values of X and Y the, that values actually we are going to find out in this section number 3. Okay, so we will understand these type of questions. Let's have one simple example. Okay, so this is a solved example from your textbook. So let me have this. So solve graphically. Okay, see, so here we go. This is what we have the question. Solve graphically means what they are expecting from us is that they are expecting the value of X and Y. Solve graphically the following linear programming problem. Your objective function is to maximize this given equation Z is equals to 9X plus 13Y. So we have to find out the value of X and Y such that this Z is the maximum. Okay, we will see how. Subject to these constraints, so 2X plus 3Y is less than or equals to 18, 2X plus Y less than or equals to 10, X and Y both are 0 or positive. Okay, values of X and Y which satisfy the given four constraints, you should maximize the Z. So this is all about the linear programming problems solution. Okay, perfect. So let's revise the section number 1 and let's try to draw these inequalities. So 2x plus 3y. So I'll be writing 2x plus 3y which is less than or equals to 18, and we have 2x plus y which is less than or equals to 10. Okay, first step is what? Write down the equation form. So 2x plus 3y equals to 18. Write down in the double intercept form. So you'll be having X by 9 plus Y by 6, it is equals to 1. So 9 and 6 are the intercepts for this line, first line. The second line is this is, so write down the first equation form, 2X plus Y equals to 10. So X by 5 plus Y, sorry, X by 5, yes, and Y by 10, it is equals to 1. So 5 and 10 are the intercept for the second line. Okay, now let's check whether the 0, 0, 0 origin is included in this feasible region or not. Okay, so for 0, 0, what you can say, what you can do is just substitute in this equation. So you'll be having 2 into 0 plus 3 into 0, it should be less than or equals to 18. So 0 is less than or equals to 18. Is this satisfied? Yes, means what you can say is origin is included in the solution set. Origin is included in the solution set. I hope you remember all these steps. Similarly, for the second line, what you can do on the same line, the second line ke liye check karo, 0, 0, सब्स्टिट्यूट करो, सो 2 इंटू 0 प्लस 0 लेस देन और इक्वल्स टू 10, सो 0 लेस देन और इक्वल्स टू 10, इज इट ट्रू? यस, मीन्स व्हाट? 0 0 इज इंक्लूडेड इन द सॉल्यूशन सेट. ओके, नाउ लेट्स हैव अ ग्राफ पेपर सो दैट वी विल बी डूइंग दिस एग्जैक्टली ऑन द ग्राफ पेपर. ओके, सो कॉपी द इमेज, लेट मी पेस्ट हियर. यस, ओके, सो लेट्स हैव ओके, आई होप इट इज विजिबल. नाउ लेट्स ड्रॉ द 2x प्लस 3y इक्वल्स टू 18 एंड 2x प्लस y इक्वल्स टू 10 लाइन्स ऑन दिस. सो फर्स्ट लेट मी हैव द x एक्सिस एंड y एक्सिस. सो शेप्स द स्ट्रेट लाइन्स एंड हियर वी गो फॉर द x एक्सिस एंड y एक्सिस. Next is the x-axis. Okay. And this is, oh, perfect. So this is what we get, the y-axis and x-axis. So let me write, this is y. Okay, this is y and this is x. Okay. First line is what it is, 2x plus 3y equals to 18, and you require the 9 and 6 are the intercepts on the x and y axis. So let's have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is my 9.9. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is my 9 point. And on the y axis, you have the 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, somewhere here I will be requiring the 6. So this is what we have, the 6 point. So let's draw the line which is passing through 6 and 9. Okay, so let's draw the line which is passing through 6 and 9. Perfect. So let's change the color. Okay, so this is what we have, the line which is passing, which is nothing but 2x plus 3y. Let me write this 2x plus 3y, it is equals to 18. This is the line. And what is the solution set? It includes the origin, matlab ye niche ka boundary rahega. It is the total. And of course, the next constraints we have is x and y both are positive. Matlab it is going to be in the first quadrant only. Okay, so this is what the solution set for the first line, which is in the first quadrant only. Now let's draw the second line, which is 2x plus y is less than or equals to 10. So what are the intercepts you get? 5 on x axis and 10 on the y axis. So let's have, so this is what you have, the 5 on the x axis. Okay, let me have the same 5 on the x axis and 10 on the y axis. So 6, 7, 8 and this is 9, and somewhere here I will get 10. Oh, sorry for this. Okay, so this is how I get the 10 somewhere here. So let's draw the line again, which is passing through these two points. Okay, so let's draw the line which is passing through the 10 and 5. Okay, so let's make it to flow pass through this 10 and 5. Okay, perfect. So this is what you get, the second equation. So let's change the color of this line. Okay, good. So this is the second equation, which is nothing but, so let's write, it is 2x plus 3, 2x plus y is equals to 10. Okay, now what will be the solution set for this? It is again below the this line, because it includes the 0 below this line and in the first quadrant only. Okay, so the same feasible solution. Now what is the common solution for this? So this is what is the common solution for this. Okay, let's highlight that. This is the common solution set for these two, and it should be in the first quadrant. Now, this is known as the feasible region. Now, of course, you know this is nothing but the feasible solution set. Now, in the feasible solution set, there are so many infinite number of values of x and y you will get. Your objective is to get the maximum value of z. okay. So you are getting these some corners in this. So first corner is, it is A. Suppose this is the B point, this is the C point, and this is the D point. Your Z will be maximum at any of these four points A, B, C, D. So let's write down the values of A, B, C, D here. So what is A? A is nothing but 0, 0. What is B? It is nothing but 5, comma 0. And what is C? C is near about, it is a 3, comma 4. Okay. So if you solve these two simultaneous equations, you will get the values. Okay. We will keep that C as it is. And we will take D as 0 and 6. D is equals to 0 and 6. Okay. Now for C, we will find out the value of, for C, we will find out the intersection point of these two lines. So 2x plus 3y equals to 18. 2x plus 3y equals to 18. And the next line is, we have is 2x plus y. 2x plus y, it is equals to 10. Okay. Let's subtract these two. So ye cancel ho gaya. Ye minus and ye minus. So this is equals to 2y. It is equals to 8. So y is coming to be 4. Okay. Y 4 aa gaya. If y is 4, let's substitute in the second equation. So you'll be having 8 plus y. Sorry, y is 4 na. So it is 2x plus 4 equals to 10. So yahan se aayega mera x is equals to 6 by 2, which is nothing but 3. Okay, so 3 comma 4 is the value of C. Coordinates of C. See, the same point you are getting. So this is somewhere here C. So this is 3 and this is 4. Okay. Now our next step is, substitute these four points in Z is equals to maximum function, which is nothing but 9x plus 13y. 9x plus 13y. See, I have already told you there are n number of points in this feasible region, but your Z is going to be maximum only at one of the four points, one of these four points. Okay, so infinite points are reduced to four points A, B, C, D. Now from these four points, we want to find out the maximum value of Z at which point. So let's substitute Z. A substitute in a Z. So Z at A equals to what? It is 9 into 0 plus 13 into 0, which is nothing but 0. Z at B is how much? So let's 9 into 5 plus 13 into 0. It is going to be 45. Z at C is how much? So it's 9 into 3 plus 13 into 4, which is not even utri 27 and terchuk 52. So ye kitna aa gaya ba 7 4 akrala 1 carry 1 6 7 8. So it is going to be 81. And Z at D is how much? It is 9 into 0 plus 13 into 6. So it is nothing but 78. Okay, now tell me which is the maximum value of Z and at which point. So of course, just observing 0, 45, 81 and 78, I can see 81 is the maximum value of Z and it is at the point C. Okay, so what is your conclusion? So the conclusion is that Z is equals to 9x plus 3y is maximum at C is equals to, in bracket, 3 comma 4. So the value of X equals to 3 and Y equals to 4 will only give you the maximum of Z is equals to 9x plus 13y. So I hope you have understood this question. Okay, so let me reconfirm it. So whether we have taken all the correct values. Oh, sorry, we have, I told it's a 52, but I have written the 54. Okay, so let's correct it. So it is 52 and it should be 79. Okay, so what is the maximum value of Z you are getting? It's 79. So Z is equals to 79 is the maximum value for the value of X equals to 3 and Y equals to 4. Okay, so this is nothing but the solution of this given LPP. Good. I hope you have understood this. See, this is very, very interesting section of this topic, LPP. And this is the heart of this topic. Let's take one more example and let's try to understand this concept again. So let's have this question. Solve graphically. Okay, let's have this much only. Okay. So let's paste here. Okay. One small correction. That is, it should be minimized, not maximized. So please make a note of this. So this should be minimized. It should be minimized. The question is misprinted there. Maximize, it should be minimized there. Solve graphically the following linear programming problem to minimize z is equals to 5x plus 2y, subject to these are the constraints. So what you can do here, let's follow the same procedure. First take the lines. So the first line is what? It is a 5x. Plus y, it is equals to 10. The second line is what we have is, okay, let me write here somewhere so that it is good to have this space, middle space, for the drawing the coordinate system. So second line is what? It is a 5x plus, sorry, it is x plus y, it is equals to 6. So let's have the double intercept form. So x by 2 plus y by 10 equals to 1. And here you have x by 6 plus y by 6 equals to 1. Okay, this is the line. Now let's check for the origin 0, 0. So whether it is included or not. So 5 into 0 plus 0 is what? It is greater than or equals to 1. So it is greater than or equals to 10. So 0 greater than or equals to 10. Is it included? No, not included, because it is not getting satisfied. What about next? So it is 0 plus 0. Again, it is greater than or equals to bola. So greater than or equals to 6. So 0 greater than or equals to 6. It is not true. So it is, again, we can say it's not included in our solution set. Okay. Now let's have the graph paper. And let's draw the coordinate system. Okay. So let's draw here somewhere. Okay, good. Let's have the lines. So I require the lines, the x-axis and y-axis. The x-axis, the y-axis. Okay. So let's take it on the right place. Okay, so let's name these points. This is what I get, the value 1. Oh, sorry, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and somewhere here I will be getting, it's a 10. Okay, so first line is what? It is 2, 10. So first is 2, so this point, and 10, this point. So let's draw the line first, which is passing through these two points. It is 2 and 10, so the line will be like this. Okay, good, perfect. So this is what we have, the line 2, 10. So let's change the color of this line so that it is visible. That is first line. So let's write the name of this line, which is a 5x plus y. 5x plus y equals to 10. What is the second line you have is x is 6 and y is 6. So 6, 6 is the second line. So 6 here and 6 here. Let's draw the line passing through these two points. So this is how you get the line. Perfect. So this is 6, 6. So let's have the same color for this. Let it. Now, what is this solution set for these two individual lines? So, of course, x and y both are the positive. So, the solution set is going to lie in the first quadrant only. And 0 is not included for both the lines. Matlab, first line ke liye solution set ye aayega. Okay, first line ke liye solution set will be like this. in the first quadrant only. For the second line also, you will have solution set like this, okay, which is in the first quadrant only, and the this origin is not included. Now what is the common region for these two? So this is what the common region for these two. Okay, perfect. And this type of region we say is the unbounded region. There is no boundary to the right in the first quadrant. Ye indefinitely chalta rahega aisa, ye indefinitely chalta rahega. Now if you want to find out the minimum value of the z, and what are the corner points here? So corner points you will be having this, let's take this point as a, which is nothing but 0, 10. Let's take this point as a b, we have to find out the coordinate of this point b, and we have this point c, which is nothing but 6, 0. Okay, so these are the corner points. So let's write down the corner points. Corner points a is nothing but 0, 10. A is 0, 10. B we have to find out, or you can take it directly from the graph. Okay, if your graph is up to the scale, you can directly take the value of B, which is nothing but 1, 5. Okay, you can cross verify this 1, 5 just by solving the simultaneous equation. Okay, intersection of these two lines is nothing but B. And what is point C? Is it is 6, 0. Okay, now let's find out the value of Z at A. So Z is equation is nothing but 5x plus 2y. It is 5x, so z I will write here. So it is 5x plus 2y. Okay, so it is 5 into 0. Oops, sorry. It is what we have, the 5 into 0 plus 2 into 10, which is nothing but 20. Z at B is nothing but 5 into 1 plus 2 into 5, which is nothing but 5 plus 10, which is nothing but 15. And Z at C is how much? You get 5 into 6 plus 2 into 0, it is 30. What is your objective? I want to have the z as the minimum. Z I want as the minimum. Okay, so what value of z gives minimum here? 20, 15 and 30. So z is minimum at 15. Okay, and the coordinate points are what? 1, 5. So what is the conclusion? So conclusion is like that. Z is minimum at B 1, 5, that is x is equals to 1 and y is equals to 5, and minimum value of z is equals to 15. Okay, z is minimum only at x equals to 5 and y equals x equals to 1 and y equals to 5. There is no other point in the solution set. So this is of course the feasible solution set. There is no other point in this feasible solution set which can give you the value less than the 50. So this is the minimum value of the z. I hope you are understanding this. Okay, great. We will take one more question and we will stop in this, and we will see what are the theory part in this section. Okay, let's take the simple example. So example number 3. See, understanding these solved examples is very, very important. Okay, so based on this, you will be having the questions in your final board examinations. So let's have this. Okay, great. Chalo, to kya bol raha hai ye? We have to form the, we have to find the maximum and minimum. Kya bol raha hai? Maximum value of, chalo, maximum nikalte hai abhi. Maximum of z. So what are the equations of the line? So you have x minus y is greater than or equals to 0. So first is what? X minus y greater than or equals to 0. And then second line we have is minus x plus 3y is less than or equals to 3. Okay, and x and y both are 0 and positive. So it is in the first quadrant. First quadrant. Let's have the equations. So it is x minus y equals to 0, and it is nothing but minus x plus 3y, it is equals to 3. These are the equations. Next, double intercept form mein kaisa likhoge? So it is nothing but x is equals to y, the slope is 1. Is it okay? Perfect. So next you can have is x upon minus 3 plus y upon 3, it is equals to 1. So this is what we get the equations of the line. So let's draw these lines. So let me take the graph paper again. So it's a copy and paste it here. Paste. Good. Let's have the x and y axis. X axis and y axis. उल्टा हो गया, ये x एक्सिस एंड वो y एक्सिस. ओके, लेट्स प्लॉट दिस लाइंस. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज व्हाट इट इज, x इक्वल्स टू y. x इक्वल्स टू y इज नथिंग बट द लाइन पासिंग थ्रू द ओरिजिन एंड द स्लोप इज ऑफ कोर्स 1. सो दैट लाइन विल बी लाइक दिस. ओके, लेट मी हैव दिस सम डिफरेंट कलर. सो दैट लाइन इज पासिंग थ्रू द ओरिजिन एंड दिस इज व्हाट वी गेट द x इक्वल्स टू y लाइन. Okay. Perfectly fine. So this is what we have, the x is equals to y line. X equals to y line. I hope you are okay with this line. Next is what? It is a minus 3 and plus 3. Minus 3 on the negative x axis. So this is what we have, the minus 1. Somewhere here minus 2 and somewhere here minus 3. Minus 3 and plus 3. So it is 1, 2 and 3. So it is plus 3. Minus 3 and plus 3. Write down the line passing through these two points. Minus 3, plus 3. So let's have the line. Minus 3, plus 3. Okay. Don't worry. We will make it pass through. It's minus 3. Perfect. Okay. So, yes, this is what we get, the minus 3 and plus 3. Now, what is the solution set for this given inequalities? So, let's have the 0, 0 here. So, first equation is what it is? X minus Y is greater than or equals to 0. So, 0 origin is on the line, no doubt. So, origin is on the line. It is greater than or equals to 0 means origin is on the line. So what will be the feasible solution for this? Either it is upar ka aayega, niche ka hai. So for that, what you can take? You can take one more point which is above the line. So let's take 0, 3. So let's take 0, 3, whether this lies in the solution set or not. So substitute 0, 3 in this equation. So 0, -3 is greater than or equals to 0. -3 is greater than or equals to. Is it true? No, it is not true. Means what you can say? 0, 3 is not included in the solution set. So of course, iska matlab kya hai? Upar ka region nahi, niche ka region is the solution set for this line. Okay, this is what we get, the solution set. Great. What about the next? Minus x plus 3y. So let's check the origin for this. So 0, 0, whether it is included or not. So it is minus 0 plus 3 into 0 is less than or equals to 3. So 0 less than or equals to, is it true? Yes, of course. So I can say 0, 0 is included in this solution set. So this is included in the solution set. Okay, so I want now is the common region to this. So what is the common region to this? So of course, so this will be the common region to this. And it should be in the first quadrant. So this is what I get, the common region. Now, what you want to have, I want to have the maximum value of z. Maximum value bola hai, and of course, this is what we have, the unbounded region. This is the unbounded region. There are infinitely many values of x and y which can give you the value of z. And from that, I cannot tell which at which point the z is going to be maximum. Because see here, as it is unbounded, the x can take value which is far greater than, it is infinity, and y also can take the infinity. Okay, so of course in such a cases I cannot find the maximum value where you have the unbounded feasible solution set. But of course I can see the minimum value of z. If the question aisa rehta ki bhai yahan pe minimum value find karo, then of course we could have given the minimum value of this z. But as they are asking for the maximum value, no, I cannot give you. Okay, so in that cases, what you can say is, as the feasible solution is the unbounded, so let's write down the conclusion, as feasible solution set is unbounded, maximum value of z cannot be determined. Okay, determined, that is perfectly fine. Okay, so if you compare this question with the previous question, in this we have the same, which is an unbounded solution set, infinite solution set, but यहाँ पे उन्होंने minimize value पूछा था. Okay, that's why we have solved for it. We get the minimum value of this set, but in this case we cannot get the maximum value. Yes, we can get the minimum, but the maximum नहीं मिलेगा. Okay, so that's great. So this is all about the finding the values of x for which the condition for the given z is getting satisfied. Good. Okay, now let's have some theory part, which is very very simple. So intentionally I have taken the questions first, and I am checking for this theory part later. Now let's see, it is very very simple. So kya bol raha hai yahan pe, dekho bhai, the solution of LPP is nothing but the values of x and y for which your given z is minimum or maximum. Okay, the same thing they have explained here. Feasible solution, so this part we have already seen in our first section. The feasible solution is nothing but the common region which can satisfy the given constraints. Okay, the same statement is there. Optimal feasible solution means what? A feasible solution which maximizes or minimizes. In the same way we have found out the value of B and the C, which give the maximum or minimum values of Z in the question number 1 and 2. Okay, so that is nothing but the optimal feasible solution. In this solution of LPP, there are infinite number of X and Y values. Optimum means what? Which can satisfy the given equation, the given Z. Okay, the same sentence is given here. Okay, for example, I can tell you that, so in this, the feasible or the optimal solution is what? Optimal solution is X is equals to 1 and Y is equals to 5. This is the optimal solution for the second question. For the first question, the x is equals to 3 and y is equals to 4 is the optimal solution for me in this question. Okay, so that is what we have, the optimal feasible solution. Feasible region, it is the same thing, the common region determined by the all the constraints we have discussed in detail in the first section. Solution of LPP, so there are two methods for this finding the solution of LPP. One is the graphical method, other is the simplex method, and simplex method is not there for your syllabus. So that's why we are only concentrating on the graphical method. Okay, next we have some definitions. So just go through this definition. What is the solution of the LPP means? A set of values of variables which satisfy. Bhai dekho, in this total topic, hum logon ko ek hi kaam karna hai ki z ki value jo bhi rahegi, 3x plus 4y, suppose this is the value of z, we have to satisfy this for maximum or for minimum. That's it. This is the only objective of this topic. Okay. Optimal feasible solution means the value of x and y which can give maximizes or minimizes as per the given conditions. Okay, so there are two theorems which are there without any proof. Okay, so this theorem number one is very very simple. The set of all feasible solutions LPP is a convex set. I hope you remember what is a convex set is. Convex set is nothing but any set which can include the line if I draw in between any two points. So this is what the convex set is. But if I take, this is a region. Okay, so this is not a convex set because this part is lying on the outside this region. So that why this is not a convex set. So all the feasible solutions, so if you see here, this is what we have, the convex set. If you draw any line in these two, okay, this is completely going to lie in this region only. Okay, so yahan pe bhi dekho, in this also you can get the line which is lying in this region only. So all the feasible solution set which are there in your LPP are this convex set only. The theorem number two, kya bol raha hai? The objective function of LPP attains its optimum value, either maximum or minimum, at least one of the vertices of the convex polygon. That's why we have taken the corner points. I hope you remember that. Okay. So while solving the questions, I have taken the corner points only. So the corner points only. This is what the corner point is. This is what the corner point is. So the maximum or the minimum value is always going to lie on the corner points only. So that's why we have removed all the infinite number of points from the feasible solution set. Okay, so this is what the theorem number two is, important one. Okay, so this is the corner point method, the same method which we have used while solving the questions. Okay, so I request all of you, please go through these. What are the steps which are very, very simple? You so follow these steps or the steps which I have followed during solving these questions. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the concept from this and you are now getting a feel of this linear programming problem at what values of x and y your z, that is the profit rahega ya cost rahega, minimum rahega, maximum rahega. Okay, so with this we will stop here and in this next video we will be looking at the exercise 7.4. So okay, thank you.